Missing two titles. We're changing. Thank you.
right, check, check, check. Check, check. Mic check, mic check.
Meet mobile meets, or 3 meets on mobile for this weekend. There is a meet.
Also, there are timelines posted. Swimmers and spectators, there are timelines posted throughout the deck area and spectator area, showing the start time for each event. While each event may start a little later than the posted timeline, no event will start earlier than the posted timeline. Again, no event will start earlier than that posted timeline. It may be a little later, but it will not be earlier. We also have breaks, scheduled breaks in between each event. I'll make the announcement on what those breaks and how long those breaks are as well. At this time, would you please rise? Remove your hats as we pay tribute to our country with our national anthem.
Bison Aquatic Club, Senior Swim Club, Aquatic Club of Enid, Greater Ada, the Greater Ada Club.
With the relays, let's not have...
The Greater Ada Swim Club, Ponca Sailfish, Lifetime Fitness, and Lifetime Fitness. Once again, this is the East or the West teams competing here at Mitch Park. Currently in Jenks at the Jenks Aquatic Club, we have the East team. So to minimize the number of swimmers on the pool deck, we have moved to once again, we in order to minimize the swimmers on the pool deck, we switched over to a two meets, one in here at Mitch Park and one in Jenks, run simultaneously this morning during prelims, and also this evening during finals. During finals this evening, I'll explain more about how that format will work, but it'll be a compiled results from our finals here in the west and the finals over in the east. Once again, you can also find on, for those of you viewing on Facebook, you can find the timeline posted on American Energy's Facebook page. This morning we're starting with the 400 free relay. So this morning we're having the females prelim events. Following the females will be the males prelim events, and then we'll have our finals events later in the evening. But for this morning, 8:30 a.m. start for the 400 free relay. We have three heats in this event. We'll take breaks in between each event to allow the swimmers to cool down or warm up. And then we'll have at 8:55 the 11 to 12 100 yard individual medley, the 13 to 19 200 yard breaststroke at 9:05, 11 to 19 100 yard free at 9:20, 11 to 12 50 yard butterfly at 9:35, the 13 to 19 year old 200 butterfly at 9:40, the 11 to 12 year old 50 yard backstroke at 9:50, the 13 to 19 100 yard back at 10 o'clock, and we'll conclude our morning session with the 13 to 19 100 yard freestyle. So it looks like we're wrapping up the last leg here of our relays for our first heat. During the relays, we have all age groups competing in all three of the heats, so we do not have like the 11, 12-year-olds and 13, 14-year-olds competing against each other. It's just based on the seed times. So right now we have two 11, 12-year-old teams at King Marlin's B relay and American Energy's A relay competing against King Marlin's 13 to 14-year-old B relay team. And our current leader, after 350 yards, is American Energy's A relay team for the 11, 12-year-olds, followed by King Marlin's 11, 12-year-old B relay team. Also, we'll keep an eye on state records for this meet. Oh, so finishing first, I apologize, finishing first is the 13, 14-year-old team from King Marlin, the B relay team, with a time of 4:10.76. American Energy's 11, 12-year-old A relay team comes second with a 4:38.35 and 4:42.29. It's King Marlin's 11 to 12 B relay team. Next up, we'll have heat number two. We'll have 11, 12, all the way up to 15, 19-year-olds competing in this next heat. While the swimmers are getting ready, I'm pulling up the Oklahoma swimming state records.
Heat number two.
We don't have any 10 and unders competing. That's right, the 10 and unders will compete this evening in the finals event with the 11 to 19-year-olds. So our 11, 12-year-old Oklahoma swimming state record is for the females, 356.04.
This is heat number two. In lane two, American Energy's 13 to 14-year-old C relay. Lane number three, American Energy's 15 to 19-year-old D relay. In lane four, Bison Aquatic's 13 to 14-year-old A relay. Lane number six, American Energy's 13 to 14 B relay. And in lane number seven, King Marlin's 11 to 12 A relay.
So once again, there is an 11, 12-year-old team, King Marlin's A relay team in lane number seven. The Oklahoma state record for that for 11, 12-year-olds is a 356.04 set by King Marlin Swim Club in 2015. The 13 to 14-year-old state record set in 2018 is a 343.90 set in 2018 by American Energy Swim Club. And then the 15 to 16-year-old state record set in looks like 2016 at 332.08 by a high school team. I don't have the official high school, but by looking at the swimmers, it looks like it was the high school team in Bartlesville that set that record. And then our 17 to 18-year-old record is a 338.32 by the Splash Club in 2018. The open record, any age group, that record is a 323.11. Set by, looks like it was a college team. It was set, looks like it may have been Oklahoma Baptist University, set in 2015 at the NAIA National Championships. So there are the records to beat. So as we come up to the halfway point in lane number four, our leaders are Bison Aquatics 13 to 14-year-old A relay team. Unfortunately, I do not have the relay cards with me, so I don't have the information about which swimmers or who's in each leg. If I recognize them, I'll give them a shout out, but right now I don't have the relay cards. We'll see if we can change that up for the during the next flight for the boys' prelims. Coming up on the last leg here, Bison Aquatics 13, 14-year-old relay team has the lead. 253.88 is their split. Followed by American Energy's D relay for the 15-19-year-olds.
Time of 356.43, Bison Aquatics, A relay for 13, 14-year-olds.
356.43, the time to beat for the 13-year-olds. One more relay heat to go, and then we'll take a 9-minute break. King Marlin's A relay for the 11, 12-year-olds. 401.91 is the time to beat for the 11-year-olds. 11, 12-year-olds. In fact, that may be the winning time. I'll have to confirm that. But next up, we have our third heat with two 13 to 14-year-old teams, and the rest are 15 to 19.
Heat number three.
So we've got 13 to 14-year-olds in the first two lanes here, American Energy in lane number one and King Marlin in lane number two.
This is your third and final heat for the women's 11 to 19 400-yard freestyle relay in lane number one from the American Energy Swim Club, our 13 to 14-year-old A relay. Lane number two, King Marlin Swim Club's 13 to 14-year-old A relay. Lane number three, American Energy's 15 to 19 B relay. Lane 4, American Energies, 15-19 A relay. Lane 5, King Marlins, 15-19 A relay. Lane 6, Sooner Swim Clubs, 15-19 A relay. Lane 7, Bison Aquatics, 15-19 A relay. And lane number 8, American Energies, 15-19 C relay.
All right, so looks like we've got, again, we're 13 to 14-year-olds in lanes 1 and 2. The American Energy in lane 1, King Marlin lane 2, as they come up here on the first 100. Very close race between the two there. In fact, it was American Energy with a 58.55 and King Marlin's with a 58.73 as they move into the second leg. For our 15 to 19-year-old girls, King Marlin's in lane A, or lane A, lane 5, their A relay in lane 5 with the lead. And American Energy in lane 4, it is a close race there too. Again, I don't have the results, or I do have the times here, 356.43 for the 13, 14-year-olds set by Bison Aquatic earlier, or in our second heat. And it looks like American Energy and King Marlin are neck and neck there in lanes 1 and 2 for the 13, 14-year-old girls. And for the 15, 19-year-old girls, also a very close race. Half body length lead as we move into the third leg. American Energy with a 147.35 and King Marlin with a 147.88, so half a second there. King Marlin, their 13, 14-year-old girls now have the lead. 156.23 was their split, and American Energy, 157.76. Both those 13, 14-year-old girls swimming out of lane 1 and 2 there. The 15, 19-year-old girls, it is still a very close competition. It's about a quarter of a body length lead. Down here to the 13, 14-year-old girls, it looks like American Energy now has the lead. 223.79 versus a 224.18 for the 13, 14-year-old girls. And over with the 15, 19-year-old girls, that's another close race. King Marlin currently with the lead, about a half body length lead, as they move into the final leg. It is a 241.54 for King Marlin and a 242.19 for American Energy. Also here with the girls, 13, 14-year-old girls, the American Energy girls have extended their lead. It's now about a two body length lead over King Marlin's 13, 14-year-old girls. American Energy's 15, 19-year-old girls with 50 yards to go has a body length lead over King Marlin's 15 to 19-year-old girls. And as the 13, 14-year-old girls come into the last 50, American Energy with a body and a half length lead. Looks like it's Texas Kite there on the anchor, swimming the anchor for American Energy. And is that Kelsey? I think it might be Kelsey Healy there in lane number 2. Can't confirm that, but it looks like it might be Kelsey. And we have a time of 334.12 from American Energy's A relay for the 15, 19-year-old girls. And for the 13, 14-year-old girls with a time of 347.72, American Energy's A relay. Ladies and gentlemen, we will take a 9-minute break. The time is now 8:46. We will resume competition with our 11 to 12-year-olds 100-yard individual medley, event 7 at 8:55 a.m. 8:55 a.m., event 7, women's 11 to 12, 100-yard individual medley, two heats in that event. All right, folks. So we don't have the official results. Once we get those official results, I'll make the announcements. Once again, we're taking a 9-minute break. Well, it looks like we'll have about 8 minutes left, but we will start competition back up at 8:55 a.m. So once again, it looks in that heat, although we don't have the official times, for the 15, 19-year-old girls, looks like it was a American Energy, King Marlin, and then in lane number six there was Sooner Swim Club. Once again, if you're following on Facebook, if you're following on Meet Mobile, what's that? Folks, at this time we're going to have a break, during our break we're going to have a word from our sponsors. Our meat sponsor, Lewis Orthodontics. All right, folks, that was a word from one of our, from our meat sponsor, Lewis Orthodontics. Without their support, and the support of our all of our sponsors, it would be extremely difficult to bring this format of our live stream to you. So we do appreciate our sponsors this weekend. Lewis Orthodontics, our meat sponsor. Today's session sponsor for the entire day is ACRS Engineering, or Communications, sorry. Also, we have hospitality sponsors to thank. Today's hospitality sponsor, Metro Diner, home of the chicken and waffles. Metro Diner, join them for lunch, breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Check chicken and waffles. You can have chicken and waffles for breakfast, for lunch, and dinner if you wanted to at Metro Diner. Once again, thanks to Metro Diner, our hospitality sponsor, providing meals for our volunteer officials, our coaches, and some of the volunteers as well. All right, folks, on the live stream, I've been told that we do not have Meet Mobile up just yet. Once we get the Meet Mobile up, I will let you guys know. But right now, we do not have Meet Mobile up. Do apologize for that inconvenience. Also, someone did ask about heat sheets. Unfortunately, we do not have heat sheets available online. They're being sold here, and therefore we are being sold here by Oklahoma Swimming, so we can't provide them online. I'm gonna try to figure out a way to get you guys heat sheets, but at some point we will get you heat sheets. Unfortunately, we don't, unlike previous meets where we have posted a link to get the heat sheets online, they are not available online for this meet. Apologies for that. Event 7 Heat 1, Event 7 Women's 11 to 1200 yard individual medley, two heats in this event.
This is event number 7, Women's 11 to 12 100 yard individual medley in lane number 1, Kyda Bradley, lane 3, Kyda Bradley, lane 4, Elena Roland, lane 5, Sarah Kingray, and in lane 6, Maya Abdalovic.
Once again, do apologize, we do not have heat sheets available online. And once we get Meet Mobile up and running, or once I'm informed that Meet Mobile's up and running, we'll make that announcement. So this is the individual medley, 100 yard individual medley for all four strokes, starting with the butterfly, moving to the backstroke, breaststroke, and then concluding with the freestyle. So it looks like our leader here in lane number 4, Elena Roland from Aquatic Club of Enid.
The time of 108.39, Elena Roland. Heat 2. Your second and final heat for event number 7. In lane 2, Harper Husbands. Lane 3, Haven Leslie. Lane 4, Sophie Pham. Lane 5, Brenna Olander. And in lane number 6, Abigail Bass. Time to beat is a 108.39, swimming that previous heat by the Aquatic Club of Enid's Elena Roland. Also a new PI there for Elena Roland. Congratulations, Elena.
All right, at the halfway point, we have King Marlin's Sophie Pham, 27.63, after concluding the butterfly and backstroke leg of this event. Also, upon conclusion of this event, we'll take a 6-minute break. So again, we're taking lots of breaks. The main reason for the breaks are because we only have the women competing this morning, and we don't have the men's events in between that would allow the female athletes to take a break in between each event. So we will put in
With a time of 101.24 from King Marlin Swim Club, Sophie Pham! Also new PR there for Sophie, congratulations. Athletes, at this time we will take a 6 minute, actually it looks like a 6 minute break. 6 minute break, the time is now 8:58. Actually, it'll be a 7 minute break. 9:05 is our start time for our next event. 9:05 for event number 9. Event 9 starts at 9:05. The time is now 8:58.
We'll get that. I'll see if we can try to get a link to that timeline posted in the comment section of either Facebook Live or YouTube Live. All right, folks, looks like we have the timeline on the live stream now, so you'll be able to see that.
Yeah, and part of that might be my problem, because I haven't told her what started the schedule.
Also, if you're able to, we'd appreciate your comments. Yeah. You know, throw some comments there in the comment section of either YouTube Live or Facebook Live, and we'll be sure to... We'll be sure to give the athletes some shout-outs as well. So if you have any comments, you want to give an athlete a shout-out, put it in the comments section. Tell us where you're watching from. I think the furthest away, furthest spectator we've had so far, I'm going to have to get someone to verify this, but we've had someone from Guam and the Philippines and Hungary. So I'll get my production crew to tell me which one's the furthest away from here, but Guam, Philippines, and Hungary are the locations we've had that are furthest so far. All right, folks, looks like 2 minutes time. We'll get started with competition here. Our next event will be event number 9, women's 13 to 19, 200-yard breaststroke. 3 heats in that event. Also, all of our events during our prelims are circle seated, meaning the top six swimmers swim in the final 3 events, but it looks like we just have 3 events here. So what circle seated means, they'll swim in lanes 4 and 5, those top 6 swimmers. Our top seated swimmer will swim in the 3rd heat. Oh, I do have some results. Excellent. 2nd seated swimmer will swim in the heat number 2. The 3rd fastest swimmer will swim in lane 4 of heat 3.
Event 9, heat 1. This is event number 9, women's 13 to 19, 200-yard breaststroke. Your first heat in lane number 2, Anna Young. Lane 3, Kristen Nieves. Lane 4, Maddie Lou. Lane 5, Callie Stoddard. Lane 6, Jessalyn Carpenter. And in lane number 7, Zoe Young. Ladies and gentlemen, these are your results for event number 7, women's 11 to 12, 100-yard individual medley. Your first alternate this evening, Sarah Kingray. In your championship final this evening, Harper Husbands, Kaida Bradley, Maya Abdelovic, Abigail Bass, Brenna Olander, Haven Leslie, Elena Rowland, and your top qualifier with a time of 101.24 from King Marlin Swim Club, Sophie Pham. The time is now 9.05. You have 30 minutes to declare your intent to scratch. Thank you.
Also, just with this weekend's format of running two meets simultaneously, we are having 2 championship finals. Top 8 swimmers from each of the regions will compete in finals this evening, and then we will compile the results. The top 8 results there will determine the finish. So we could have, for example, a swimmer this evening swimming or winning the championship final for the West and possibly coming in 2nd, for example, if the swimmer from the East in Jenks swims a faster time. Once again, championship final, top 8 swimmers make it to the championship final. For the East and the West, we'll have 16 swimmers in the championship finals run simultaneously this evening, with the compiled results determining the overall finish. And because we're having those
this is heat number two in lane two, Rachel Young. Lane three, Ryan Kent. Lane four, Ashley Leader. Lane five, Brianna Ridbath. And in lane number seven, Grace Revolution.
This is the second of our three circle seated heats for the women's 13-19 200 yard breaststroke. Our current leader, Sooner Swim Club's Ashley Leader, with a 149.56 after the first 150 there. Following Ashley is Brianna Ridbath from American Energy Swim Club, lane number five. And King Marlin's Ryan Kent in lane number three. 205.16 is Ryan's split. Finisher there, 228.50, Sooner Swim Club's Ashley Leader, followed by Brianna Ridpath, 233.09. 228.50 is the current time to beat.
This is your third and final heat for event number nine. In lane two, Gwen Mendez. Lane three, Natalie Dennison. Lane four, Bria Boyle. Lane five, Kate Jansen. Lane six, Sasha Tachenko. And in lane number seven, Jordan Lavette. Upon conclusion of this event, we are scheduled for a 4-minute break, with the next event starting at 9:20 a.m.
So after the first 50, it is your top seed, Bria Borm from Sooner Swim Club. Split of 31.82, followed by Kate Jansen from King Marlin Swim Club. 34.36 is her split. With 50 to go, it's Bria Borm, 148.24. followed by Kate Jansen, 153.09. And upon conclusion of these events, we'll have the results for the swimmers that make the finals. Since we have 13, 14, and 15 to 19-year-olds in these three heats, there'll be two separate announcements for finals.
With a time of 2:27.46 from Student Swim Club, Bria Brown!
That's 9 minutes. All right. Six.
Six.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we'll take a six-minute break. Six-minute break and conclude competition at 9:20 a.m. Our next event is event 13, women's 11 to 19, 100-yard freestyle, five heats in that event. That event will resume at 9:20 a.m. Thank you.
Stage area. Heat number one by the box then.
Our next event, event number 13, women's 11 to 19, 100 yard freestyle. Five heats in that event. Last three heats are circle seated heats.
Event 13, heat one. This is event 13, women's 11 to 19, 100 yard freestyle. Five heats in this event. This is heat number one in lane one, Abigail Bass. Lane two, Brenna Olander. Lane three, Kyna Bradley. Lane four, Sienna Brewer. Lane five, Kara Crossley. Lane six, Jasper Jernigan. And in lane number seven, Maya Avdalovic.
Once again, five heats in this event. This is heat number one. Heats three, four, and five are our circle seeded heat. Top six seeds coming into the event swim in those three heats. The first and sixth heat. Our first and sixth will swim in heat five. Our second and fifth seed will swim in heat four. And our third and fourth seed in heat number three.
The time of 58:35 from American Energy Swim Club, Sienna Brewer.
Stop.
Heat two.
Looks like a new personal best there for Sienna Brewer. Winning that heat, 58:35 is her time.
This is heat number two in lane one, Callie Stoddard. Lane two, Madison Shearer. Lane three, Caroline Olszewski. Lane four, Krista Parker. Lane five, Natalie Flint. Lane six, Jessalyn Carpenter. Lane number seven, Ashlyn Busey. And in lane number eight, Elena Rowland!
Once again, 58:35. That swim there by Sienna Brewer in lane number four there for American Energy. Current leader right now is Bison Aquatics' Ashlyn Busey with a 27:68 for her first 50 split. 13-year-old Ashlyn Busey.
The time of 57:19 from Ponca Sailfish, Jessalyn Carpenter! You three. This is heat number three in lane one, Isabella Little. Lane two, Caroline Glover. Lane three, Dylan Beeson. Lane four, Lainey Jones. Lane five, Avery Littlefield. Lane six, Allie Lewis. Lane seven, Sarah Ramos. And in lane number eight, Piper Lewandowski.
This is our first of our circle seeded heats with our third and fourth seed, Lainey Jones and Avery Littlefield. In lanes three and, or four and five. Looks like it's going to be Avery Littlefield taking this one, although it's very close here with Avery and Lainey Jones.
Time of 53:96 from American Energy Swim Club, Avery Littlefield! Heat four. This is heat number four in lane one, Kinley Manuel. Lane two, Kelsey Healy. Lane 3, Tori Whitbeck. Lane 4, Lydia Lafferty. Lane 5, Lily Richter. Lane 6, Emma Smith. Lane 7, Haley McFarlane. And in lane 8, Liv Smith.
This is heat number 4. With our second and fifth seeded swimmers. Second fastest swimmer coming into the event, Lydia Lafferty from American Energy Swim Club. And number 5 is Lily Richter from American Energy Swim Club.
With a time of 53.48 from American Energy Swim Club, Lydia Lafferty.
Heat five.
Your fifth and final heat for event 13. In lane 1, Jaden Hooper. Lane 2, Daniel Horst. Lane 3, Macy Lewis. Lane 4, Kate Jansen. Lane 5, Hannah Agee. Lane 6, Ashley Leader. Lane 7, JD Brister. And in lane 8, Lindsay Mendoza!
Looks like our top seed coming in, Kate Jansen from King Marlin Swim Club, lane number 4. 25.73 was her split there. Looks like Kate will take this one, body length lead here.
The time of 53.17 from King Marlin Swim Club, Kate Jansen! Ladies and gentlemen, the time is now 9:26. We will resume competition with event number 15. Women's 11 to 12, 50-yard butterfly at 9:35. We will resume competition. That means we'll have a 9-minute break. Once again, 9:35, event number 15, women's 11 to 12, 50-yard butterfly. Thank you.
A saying that I want our coaches always to keep in mind is create an environment where champions are inevitable. This team is a place where leadership grows, it is fostered, it is developed, and kids move on to be great leaders.
And I never dreamed that I'd live in Oklahoma and be a part of the American Energy Swim Team, but now my son has had the benefits of swimming, getting that discipline, those life skills, the memories that last a lifetime, and the friendships. That's the best part, is the friendships that you make.
My favorite thing about AESC is that you're part of something bigger than yourself.
I love swimming because I get to do exercise and see my friends.
I learn from swimming to push myself.
I get to hang out with my friends and have fun, and I get to work hard.
Swimming has taught me that hard work pays off.
Kern McGee Swim Club started in May of 63. We became the Chesapeake Swim Club, moved to American Energy Swim Club. It is still that name today. Early years of swimming, Kern McGee swam at the downtown Kern McGee building, and it was a 3-lane, 20-yard pool. And normally we had 20 to 30 swimmers in at one time. Swimming taught discipline, it taught hard work, and it taught perseverance. The most important part of the swim club was relationships, and the people were what made it important. My life has been blessed by being a part of the Kern McGee Swim Club.
If I work really hard and I support have good support around me, I can accomplish lots of things outside of the pool as well. So I think that drive carried me through to break a lot of boundaries as a woman in the professional world. And I hope that's something that I can pass on to my kids through swimming as well.
Swimming has 100% shaped me to who I am today. It taught you tenacity and to not be entitled. And I think of the people that I grew up with swimming, you know, it translates into successful careers, successful marriages, successful lives, and however you define that.
You're in this big environment and you're one of eight. You know, crowds and stands may or may not be full, but I think being in front of groups like that helped him.
Teaching me to be consistent in everything that I do.
It really taught me the importance of leading by example.
Make the difficult decisions that other people won't make. I think it's really taught me how to do that, to be a good example for the younger kids on the team.
So what's American Energy known for? Well, we produce leaders.
Fourteen-year-old 200-yard breaststroke, our second alternate this evening, Zoe Young. First alternate, Grace Grote-Lucian in the championship final this evening. Anna Young, Ryan Kent, Jordan Labette, Gwen Mendez, Jessalyn Carpenter, Maddie Liu, Callie Stoddard, and our top qualifier this morning with a time of 2:33.09 and new personal best from American Energy Swim Club, Brianna Ridpow. For our 15- to 19-year-old girls in our championship final, it's Rachel Young, Sasha Tachenko, Natalie Dennison, Kristen Nieves, Kate Jansen, Ashley Leader, and our top qualifier for our 15 to 19-year-old girls with a time of 2:27.46 from Sooner Swim Club, Bria Borum. Those ladies have 30 minutes to declare their intent to scratch.
Thank you.
Event 17, Heat 1. This is heat number one, your only heat for event 17, women's 11 to 12, 50 yard butterfly in lane one, Abigail Bash, lane two, Haven Leslie, lane three, Elena Rowland, lane four, Sophie Pham, lane five, Caroline Olszewski, lane six, Kyler Bradley, and in lane number seven, Skylar Brown. And swim club, Sophie Pham. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we will take a 5-minute break. Looks like about 4 minutes and 20 second break. 9:40 we'll resume competition with event 19, women's 13 to 19, 200 yard butterfly. Once again, 9:40 a.m. we'll resume with event 19, women's 13 to 19, 200 yard butterfly. Ladies and gentlemen, these are your results for event 13. Girls, 11 to 12, 100 yard freestyle in your championship final this evening. Maya Abdulovic, Brenna Olander, Abigail Bass, Jasper Jernigan, Kyla Bradley, Caroline Olszewski in your top qualifier with a time of 58.17. Elena Rowland from the Aquatic Club of Enid. These are your results for the girls 13 to 14, 100 yard freestyle. Your second alternate this evening, Callie Stoddard. First alternate, Sienna Brewer. In your championship final this evening, Isabella Little, Ashlyn Busey, Jessalyn Carpenter, Caroline Glover, Sarah Ramos, Kelsey Healy, Lady Jones. And your top qualifier with a time of 54.16 from American Energy Swim Club, Macy Lewis. These are your results for women's 15 to 19, 100 yard freestyle. Your second alternate, JD Brister. First alternate, Ashley Leader. In your championship final this evening, Hannah Agee, Emma Smith, Allie Lewis, Lily Rector, Tori Whitbeck, Avery Littlefield, Lydia Lafferty, and your top qualifier with a time of 53.17 from King Marlin Swim Club, Kate Jensen. Folks, the time is now 9:37. Athletes, you have 30 minutes to declare your intent to scratch. Ladies and gentlemen, event number seven, women's 11 to 12, a 100 yard individual medley has closed with no changes. Once again, event seven, women's 11 to 12, 100 yard individual medley has closed with no changes. Thank you. Last call for event 19, women's 13 to 19, 200 yard butterfly, one heat. Once again, last call, event 19, women's 13 to 19, 200 yard butterfly. Event 19, Heat 1. This is your first and only heat for event number 19, women's 13 to 14-year-old 200-yard butterfly. That's right, all our competitors are 13 and 14 years old. In lane number one, Michaela Davis. Lane two, Catherine Herrick. Lane three, Nora Weber. Lane four, Texakite. Lane five, Megan Jansen. Lane six, Alondra Ortiz-Gondry. And in lane seven, Roxy Padova.
So we do not have any 15, 19-year-olds competing in this event this weekend. So this is our 13, 14-year-olds. Every one of the competitors here are 13 or 14, which means with only seven competitors, if they all have legal swims, they'll move on to finals this evening. All right, folks, it looks like our Jenks meet mobile is up. So the meet mobile for the Jenks, the Oklahoma Swimming Championship for the East is up. Our West has yet to come up. Once that comes up, I'll let you know. Once again, our East, our Oklahoma Swimming East Championship is up on meet mobile, but not the West. So once we get that up, I'll let you know. So they got after the first 150, it's our top seed, Texakite, 136.37 is her split, followed by King Marlin's Meg Jansen, 141.26. I do see the shout-outs coming in there, so after this next break, I'll be sure to give some shout-outs to our athletes. With a time of 2:12.76 from American Energy Swim Club, Texakite! Finishing second there in that heat, 2:16.88, King Marlin's Meg Jansen. And King Marlin's Nora Weber takes third in this heat, 2:19.94. Upon the conclusion of this event, we will have event number 23, women's 11 to 12 50-yard backstroke. That event will start at 9:50 a.m. for that event. Ladies and gentlemen, the time is now 9:43. We'll take a 7-minute break. Resume competition at 9:50 with event number 23, women's 11 to 12, 50-yard backstroke. Once again, competition will resume at 9:50 a.m. with event 23, women's 11 to 12, 50-yard backstroke. Thank you. Time is now 9:45. You have 30 minutes to declare your intent to scratch. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we're going to recognize a few of our seniors, our high school seniors, who will be moving on after they graduate in May or June. First up, from Bison Aquatic Club, Kristen Nieves from Edmond Memorial High School. Kristen plans to attend the University of Nebraska in the fall, majoring in meteorology and climatology. Folks, let's give a big round of applause for our high school senior, Kristen Nieves. Next up from American Energy Swim Club, Jaden Hooper. Jaden attends Stillwater High School. Upon graduation, she plans to major in nutritional sciences, also plans to swim, although she is undecided on a college right now. So that'll be a surprise come May 1st, I think, is final decision day. Let's give a big round of applause to Jaden Hooper! And finally, last but not least, American Energy's Lily Richter. Lily attends Edmond North High School. Lily plans to attend the University of Oklahoma. Boomer, Sooner. University of Oklahoma, and she plans to major in visual communications. Lily Richter! Also, athletes, coaches, if you have seniors who are graduating this spring, send me the information and we'll make sure that we do some shout-outs during our breaks this weekend. Once again, congratulations to Kristen, Jaden, and Lily. Last call for event 23, women's 11 to 12, 50-yard backstroke. One heat. Heat number one. Please make your way to the starting blocks. Thank you.
I still had a minute.
The spotlight is off of you for that minute. You missed.
Event 23, heat one. Ladies and gentlemen, this is event 23, women's 11 to 12, 50-yard backstroke. Your first and only heat. In lane number one, Haley Hunt. Lane two, Jasper Jernigan. Lane three, Caroline Olszewski. Lane four, Sophie Pham. Lane five, Brenna Olander. Lane six, Sarah Kingray. Lane seven, Haven Leslie. And in lane eight, Skylar Brown! The
with a time of 27.67 from King Marlin Swim Club, Sophie Pham. Ladies and gentlemen, the time is now 9:50 a.m. We'll have a 10-minute break and resume competition at 10 o'clock, 10 a.m. with event 25, women's 13 and 19, 100-yard backstroke. Event 25, women's 13 and 19, 100-yard backstroke at 10 a.m. Thank you. And these are your results for you. Event 19, girls 13 to 14, 200-yard butterfly. In your championship final this evening, Michaela Davis, Roxy Padova, Catherine Herrick, Alondra Ortiz-Gondry, Nora Weber, Meg Jansen, and your top qualifier with a time of 2:12.76 from American Energy Swim Club, Texarkite. Time is now 9:51. You have 30 minutes to declare your intent to scratch. Thank you.
A saying that I want our coaches always to keep in mind is create an environment where champions are inevitable. This team is a place where leadership grows. It is fostered, it is developed, and kids move on to be great leaders.
And I never dreamed that I'd live in Oklahoma and be a part of the American Energy Swim Team, but now my son has had the benefits of swimming, getting that discipline, those life skills, the memories that last a lifetime, and the friendships. That's the best part, is the friendship that you make.
My favorite thing about AESC is that you're part of something bigger than yourself.
I love swimming because I get to do exercise and see my friends.
I learn from swimming to push myself.
I get to hang out with my friends and have fun, and I get to work hard.
Swimming has taught me that hard work pays off.
Kern McGee Swim Club started in May of 63. We became the Chesapeake Swim Club, moved to American Energy Swim Club. It is still that name today. Early years of swimming, Kern McGee swam at the downtown Kern McGee building, and it was a three-lane, 20-yard pool. And normally we had 20 to 30 swimmers in at one time. Swimming taught discipline, it taught hard work, and it taught perseverance. The most important part of the swim club was relationships, and the people were what made it important. My life has been blessed by being a part of the Kern McGee Swim Club.
If I work really hard and I support have good support around me, I can accomplish lots of things outside of the pool as well. So I think that drive carried me through to break a lot of boundaries as a woman in the professional world. And I hope that's something that I can pass on to my kids through swimming as well.
Swimming has 100% shaped me to who I am today. It taught you tenacity and to not be entitled. And I think of the people that I grew up with swimming, you know, it translates into successful careers, successful marriages, successful lives, and however you define that.
You're in this big environment and you're one of eight. You know, crowds and stands may or may not be full, but I think being in front of groups like that helped him. You know, I know he's never been afraid to stand up in front of a group and give a talk.
Club swimming really teaches you how to handle success. You kind of learn a lot of leadership, but also like personal accountability. You don't always get that in other sports.
Work ethic and then time management. Not everyone has to get up at 5 a.m. and then come back after a two-hour workout, go to school, and then do it again.
The one thing that swimming helped me with was my self-confidence also. Even though I didn't have the talent, but I could still see that the persistence and the hard work would end up paying off.
You don't have to be a leader by name necessarily to have a huge impact on your teammates and the team culture. And I think that's where our clubs really thrived, because you've had people step up and
create a great environment that everyone wants to come see their friends and hang out.
Swimming has impacted my life by teaching me to be consistent in everything that I do.
It's really taught me the importance of leading by example.
Make the difficult decisions that other people won't make. I think it's really taught me how to do that, to be a good example for the younger kids on the team.
So what's American Energy known for? Well, we produce leaders.
Before we get started, I've been told that Meet Mobile is up and running. We do apologize for the delay. Meet Mobile is now up and running. You can search for our Meet Mobile results and also the Jinx results just by searching OKS. OKS State Short Course Championship. Once again, Meet Mobile results are now up. Thank you for your patience. Event 25, heat 1. This is heat number 1 for event 25, women's 13 to 19, 100 yard backstroke. In lane number 1, Callie Stoddard. Lane 2, Maddie Lou. Lane 3, Jessalyn Carpenter. Lane 4, Trista Dewerson. Lane 5, Emma Welcher. Lane 6, Kira Crossley. Lane 7, Alondra Ortiz-Gondry. And in lane number 8, Maisie Finch!
This is the first heat of four for event number 25, women's 13 to 19 year old 100 yard backstroke. Heat number 2, 3, and 4 will be our circle seated heats. Top qualifier in coming into this event, King Marlin's Kate Jansen, time of 54.87 is her top time. The time of 105.69 from Ponca Sailfish, Jessalyn Carpenter. Heat two. This is heat number 2. In lane 1, Jaden Hooper. Lane 2, Allie Lewis. Lane 3, Kelsey Healy. Lane 4, Macy Lewis. Lane 5, Lydia Lafferty. Lane 6, Emma Smith. Lane 7, Lily Barker. And in lane number 8, Kylie Elmeyer. The first of our circle seated heats are third and fourth seed coming into the event. Macy Lewis, American Energy, seeded number 3 coming into this event. Lydia Lafferty, seeded number 4 coming into this event. Macy in lane 4, Lydia in lane 5. Ladies and gentlemen, event number 9 has closed with no changes. Event 9, girls 13 to 14, 200 yard breaststroke, and women's 15 to 19, 200 yard breaststroke, has closed with no changes. Thank you.
With a time of 57.88 from American Energy Swim Club and a new PR, Macy Lewis!
Heat number 3 next. Heat 3 featuring our 2nd and 5th seeded swimmers coming into the event. Ella Turner, American Energy Swim Club, 57.97 is her seed time. And Hannah Agee from Sooner Swim Club, 58.62.
This is heat number 3. In lane 1, Ashley Leader. Lane 2, Lily Rector. Lane 4, lane 3, Tori Whitbeck. Lane 4, Ella Turner. Lane 5, Hannah Agee. Lane 6, Janie Brister. Lane 7, Caroline Glover. And in lane 8, Natalie Flint!
So once again, this is heat number 3 of 4 heats. Our number 2 seed overall, Ella Turner, coming into this event with the lead.
With a time of 58.87 from American Energy Swim Club, Ella Turner! Heat 4. This is your 4th and final heat for event 25. In lane 1, Lainey Jones. Lane 2, Texakite. Lane 3, Avery Littlefield. Lane 4, Kate Jansen. Lane 5, Gracie Shepherd. Lane 6, Bria Borum. Lane 7, Simone Villaruel. And in lane number 8, Ashlyn Goosey.
So our final heat. Heat number 4, our top seed. Coming into the event, Kate Jansen with the lead, 27:42 is her split, followed by her teammate from King Marlin Swim Club, Gracie Shepherd. 28:67 was Gracie's split. Looks like Kate is going to take this one.
And a time of 56:71 from King Marlin Swim Club, Kate Jensen. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we're going to take a 10-minute break. We'll resume competition at 10:16 a.m. with one heat of the women's 13-19 1,000-yard freestyle. Once again, one heat of event 29, women's 13-19 1,000-yard freestyle. Scheduled to take place at 10:16 a.m. Time is now 10:06. Ladies and gentlemen, these are your results for event 23, women's 11-12, 50-yard backstroke. In your championship final this evening, Haley Hunt, Skylar Brown, Haven Leslie, Sarah Kingray, Jesper Jernigan, Brenna Olander, and your top qualifier with a time of 31:35 from King Marlin Swim Club, Caroline Olszewski! The time is 10:07. You have 30 minutes to declare your intent to scratch.
All right, folks. One more event, one more swim. Event 129, women's 13-19, 1,000-yard freestyle. A.M.
Ladies and gentlemen, event number 13, our women's 100-yard freestyle. All age groups have closed with no changes. Once again, event 13, girls 11 to 12, 13 to 14, and 15 to 19, 100-yard freestyle has closed with no changes. Thank you. Also, at this time, let's do some shout-outs. We've had some people watching on Facebook Live and YouTube Live. Here's some shout-outs from YouTube Live. Bryce McMinn, watching from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, says, go Nora Wimber! Joe Olander, grandparents, watching Brenna Olander from Hawarden, Iowa. Margaret Lopez says, go Sarah! Lois and Jim Seafelt, grandparents, watching Brenna Olander from Muskego, Wisconsin. And Bryce McMinn says, go Nora, your Pittsburgh fan club is rooting for you. That's on YouTube Live. Let me move over here to Facebook Live and see if we've got any shout outs there. All right, folks, here we go. We got some shout outs here from on Facebook Live from Ben and Becky. Well, let's make that Becky Hayes because I think Ben is in the house. So Becky Hayes says, watching from the TYR or Tier San Antonio Pro Series, she says, good luck to all. While Becky's watching, let's all give Aiden Hayes a big round of applause as he's competing this week at the Tier Pro Series. Aiden came in 10th place overall in the 200 butterfly last night, and I'm not sure what he's competing in this morning, but let's all give Aiden Hayes a big round of applause as we wish him luck at the Tier Pro Series. All right, I think we can do better than that, but we'll save that for the next round. Also, King Marlin Swim Club says, swim fast Marlins.
Ruth Ann Jacqueline says, swim fast, Grace Groat Lucian. I'm watching you from Houston, Texas. And Bibosh Loma and Phil Schweitzer give three rounds of applause and three jumping up and down emojis. Look at that. Oh, actually, that's from Sing Atu for Bibosh and Phil. While we're on the subject, let's give a big round of applause to Broadcast Elements, who brings this live stream live to all of our relatives throughout the country and world. Once again, Broadcast Elements, Bibosh Loma and Phil Schweitzer. Why don't you boys stand up? They are standing up. Okay. All right. Again, thanks to Bibosh and Phil. They've added some new technology this week into our live stream with our order of finish now showing up live instead of the scoreboard that we've had in the past. So they're continuously adding technology. Again, we'd like to also thank our meet sponsor, Lewis Orthodontics. Lewis Orthodontics. Home of the $99 a month braces. Not the $99 braces, but the $99 a month braces. Lewis Orthodontics, our meet sponsor. Also, our session sponsor this week, today, is ACRS. ACRS, let's see, I'm pulling it up right now, James. While that's pulling up, let's also thank our hospitality sponsor today, Metro Diner. Metro Diner, home of the chicken and waffles, where you can have chicken and waffles for breakfast, for lunch, and dinner. Again, Metro Diner, located there on Memorial. Let's give a round of applause to Metro Diner for providing the hospitality for today. Yes, 3 minutes. First call for event 29. Heat 2 for event 29. First call, women's 13 to 19, 100 yard freestyle. Also, big shout out to our session sponsor for today, ACRS Telecommunication Engineers, providing consulting and engineering services across the country for a variety of broadband providers, including rural telephone companies, cable TV operators, WSIPs, electric operatives, municipalities, and Native American tribes. Our session sponsor today, ACRS Telecommunications Engineers. And also, let's give a big round of applause to all our volunteers this morning, all of our volunteers, our officials. Big round of applause to our volunteers for helping make this meet happen. Watch it there, Craig. We almost had a 5-minute delay there, but we avoided that. All right.
right, last call for event 29, women's 13 to 19 100 yard freestyle. Heat number two.
I'll do it when they start, after they start. So Jay.
Event 29, heat two. This is event 29, women's 13 to 19, 1,000 yard freestyle, your second heat. In lane number three, Kristen Nieves. Lane four, Gwen Mendez. And in lane five, Grayson Simpson. Once again, just a reminder that Heat 1 will be swum in finals this evening. Heat 1 of our 13, 19, 1,000 yard freestyle will be swum during finals this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, event number 17, women's 11 to 12, 50 yard butterfly has closed with no changes. Once again, event 17, women's 11 to 12, 50 yard butterfly has closed with no changes. Thank you.
What's up, my man? How you doing? I'm doing well.
All right, folks, so this is event 29, women's 13 to 19, 1,000 yard freestyle. Heat number two. We've got Kristen Nieves from Bison Aquatic Club in lane number three, Gwen Mendez from King Marlin Swim Club in lane number four, and Grayson Simpson swimming unattached in lane number five. Our top eight swimmers in the 1,000 will swim this evening during the finals. It'll be the first event after relays this evening. I will confirm that, but it will be, again, top eight swimmers for this event will swim this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, these are your results for event 25, girls 13 to 14, 100 yard backstroke. Your second alternate this evening, Maisie Finch. First alternate, Kara Crossley. In your championship final this evening, Callie Stoddard, Jessalyn Carpenter, Caroline Glover, Lady Jones, Ashlyn Busey, Texa Kite, Kelsey Healy. And your top qualifier with a personal best time of 57.88 from American Energy Swim Club, Macy Lewis. These are your results for women's 15 to 19 100 yard backstroke. Your first, second alternate this evening, Allie Lewis. First alternate, Bria Borum. In your championship final this evening, Avery Littlefield, Tori Whitbeck, Emma Smith, Hannah Agee, Lydia Lafferty, Gracie Shepherd, Ella Turner, and your top qualifier with a time of 56.71 from King Marlin Swim Club, Kate Jensen. Ladies, the time is now 10:23. You have 30 minutes to declare your intent to scratch. Thank you. Also, ladies and gentlemen, event number 19, girls 13 to 14, 200 yard butterfly has closed with no changes. Once again, event 19, girls 13 to 14, 200 yard butterfly has closed. No changes. Thank you. All right, folks. Looks like we're wrapping up the second half of our 1,000 here. 1,000 yard freestyle, 40 lengths of the pool, or 20 laps as the kids will call it. Currently we are coming up on leg number 27. So I'm a little rusty on the math. That's leg 27, that is 675 yards. So they're coming up on the 700 yard mark. Our current leader in lane 5 there, swimming unattached, is Grayson Simpson. All ladies are still on the same same number of leg. Glenn Mendez there in second, and Kristen Nieves in third currently. So we've got Grayson with a split there of 8:34.44 after 700. Gwen Mendez 8:39.83, and Kristen Nieves 8:41.34. So we've got some of those underwater shots there from Broadcast Elements with their underwater drone camera.
right, folks, we're on that bell lap here. And Grayson Simpson swimming out of fast, 11:42.66. Those are some loud bells. Greg Mendez, King Marlin Swim Club, 11:46.86, her split. And Kristen Yeves, 11:52.94, her split there. Let's see, Grayson's time coming in was a 12:37.21. Gwen, a 12:36.43. And Kristen, 12:37.95. And we're on a time of 12:17.14 and a new PR. Swimming unattached, Grayson Simpson! Congratulations on that new PR, Grayson.
1,000 kids asked if the pool would be open for them to cool down
there. Yeah. All right, folks, that's a wrap. The competition pool is open for the swimmers of the 1,000 there to cool down. And we will be back with competition at 12:30 for the boys. Yes. Prelim events. So once again, competition pool is currently open for those swimmers who swim the 1,000 to cool down. And for those of you on the live stream, thanks again for your participation, for watching. We hope you enjoyed our first prelim session of the weekend. The Friday girls session will be back at 12:30. Actually, we'll be back live probably a half an hour earlier than that at 12, around 12 o'clock for the boys live stream.